Chale everyone, come some yinale. Welcome to Leh. Today our topic of discussion is on tourism in Ladakh. Ladakh is very popular with tourists after the release of Three Idiots, of course. Because, you know, in Three Idiots, they have shown the Pangong Lake in Ladakh as a beautiful lake, and since then people have been trying different routes in Ladakh, and all the planes and all the trips and everything has become so expensive. Going to Ladakh, coming back from Ladakh, the plane fares, everything is really expensive. But I must say, Ladakh offers you a different, unique experience that you would not find it anywhere else in India, not even in the Northeast. Let me introduce Ladakh. Where is it? How to go about Ladakh? Where all things are there in Ladakh? And you know how to plan Ladakh. So Ladakh is in Jammu and Kashmir state of India. And then Ladakh could also be told as a place wherein you can find age-old monasteries, you can find beautiful quaint lakes, you can roam around nice markets, and then all in the backdrop of Himalayas. But apart from that, people very less know about the other place in Ladakh. Now Ladakh is not only about age-old monasteries, it's not only about Khardunga Pass, it's not only about Pangong Lake, but Ladakh is much, much more. So today we are going to explore what exactly is in Ladakh. Now if you go to Ladakh and if you only go for those places which are, you know, now they have become really famous, but I should tell you there are very much adventure options in Ladakh as well. You could go to whitewater rafting in Indus and Zanskar, which has very nice rapids, okay? You can also go for mountaineering in Ladakh. There's Markha Valley wherein you can go. There's also called a frozen river where, you know, in winters people do trekking, mostly foreigners. Then there is a wide variety of wildlife in Ladakh which is yet to be explored. So today my topic of discussion of Ladakh is not just the famous places, but places which you might not know about. There are two ways you can reach Ladakh. Ladakh can be either reached by road, which is like, you know, you can go from Manali to Leh, or you can go from Srinagar to Leh. There is one more way, which is like, you know, you can reach by plane from Delhi to Ladakh. These are the only two ways in which you can reach Ladakh. Now in winters, the only way you can reach Ladakh is by plane. Ladakh is cut from the all over place of India. In summers, which is mostly by the end of May till the end of October, what you can do is you can go by road, either by road or you can take a plane, you can take a flight. But of course, the flight fares are really expensive because a lot of people go to Ladakh these days. So let me start with Ladakh basics, what districts Ladakh have, what are places Ladakh have, how can we go about in Ladakh once we reach there, what is the Ladakh temperature, how are the people there, are they friendly, are they bad, are they good, are they safe, Ladakh is safe, Ladakh is peaceful. Let's discuss all that in today's episode. Ladakh can be divided into two districts, which is the district of Leh and the other one is the district of Kargil. Kargil comes in the district of Ladakh. Kargil has really become famous after the 1999 war, and Ladakh is a very peaceful state. Leh is a very peaceful district in Ladakh. Ladakh can also be divided into four parts, which could be Nubra, Zanskar, Sham and Changhang. Now, there's one more lake which is called Somrori, which comes in the Changhang region of Ladakh. So there are many aspects of Ladakh which, you know, today I'm going to discuss. Okay. Once you reach the Ladakh airport, what people advise you is take a two-day rest to acclimatize at the high altitude. Ladakh itself is at 11,000 feet, and since it is at a very high altitude, you might experience a lot of difficulty in breathing, and you might experience a lot of dizziness or, you know, faintiness or lack of oxygen if you just reach Ladakh and do not take rest for at least half a day. My experience about Ladakh is I went in winters in April. I went 3 years back. And that time Ladakh was freezing cold. It was freezing cold. It was in minus degrees. During winters, the oxygen level in Ladakh really goes down. Okay, it really, really goes down. You feel that there's a very low level of oxygen which is there. Even if you climb the stairs, you feel the low level of oxygen which is there in Ladakh region. Okay, when I went in summers, which was like, you know, May, and then I went again in October, it was, the oxygen level had slightly improved because of the trees which has grown in the mountains in Ladakh, you know. So this is what happens. So when you go in the winters, the temperatures are really, really low, and the temperatures are really low, and the oxygen level is really low. When you come in the summers, even then the oxygen is low. People say that 80% of, there's only 80% of the oxygen in Ladakh. So even if you go in summers, you would slightly feel a difference of oxygen in, you know, when you land there. So the most important thing when you reach to Ladakh is take a half a day rest, half a day or one day rest if you're elder or an adult. If you're elderly, if you're coming with your mom, dad, take a one day rest, whatever. Take a rest, acclimatize with the environment there, and then move on to higher further destinations, you know, higher altitudes. Now, once we reach Ladakh, how are we gonna, which places are we gonna see, and what all can we do in Ladakh? Now, Ladakh is very famous for Pangong Lake, which takes around 5 hours from Leh, and it's a very beautiful lake. It's a very beautiful lake. You can either go there, stay overnight at a campsite in summers, or in winters, the lake is whole frozen. It's a very beautiful sight, even if you go in winters or you go in summers. In summers, what happens that since the lake is not frozen, you have the very nice blue colored water of the lake, and it you know, during the whole day, if you sit the whole day near the Pangong Lake, you would see the reflection of the mountains which come there, and the lake changes